4 months after our album On All Fours was released into the world, we played a socially distanced show, well, two socially distanced shows at the Dome in Tufnell Park. Two shows in one day, which we'd done before, but never like this.
People were assigned seats at designated tables, no mingling, no standing up during the gig.
It was just a really exciting moment when we realised that we could do this show.
It was the first opportunity that we had to, when the restrictions were lifted enough, that we could go ahead and play a socially distanced show.
To the pandemic, we took playing for granted a little bit. So even though, you know, it wasn't, like, we're not going to lie to you and say it was an ideal situation, because we all know that's not true. But in a way, you know, like, I feel like through doing the seated show, it's like just any show that we were able to do at that point, it's like we were all so bang up for it.
Thank you.
was amazing to see the band play the whole record from start to finish.
Learn on all fours again because we hadn't been in a room with each other for so long.
I think what was just really important for us was to kind of relearn the album and get familiar with it again and immerse ourselves in a way that we were in a state of having when recording. It'd been so long since we'd had that, you know, like maybe a year or two even.
There was lots of like listening to the record and remembering chords.
Challenge of trying to recreate a record that we've made in the studio and gone crazy with electronics and percussion and things like that, and try and learn all the parts. You know, we'd put down extra guitar parts in the studio, so yeah, just the challenge of trying to pull it off live. But because we haven't played, a lot of them we'd never played live at all, and some of them had changed from the way that we were playing them before we recorded them.
Thank you. preparing for the show, we were just like in our studio pretty much every other day, just running through the songs on the album, trying to play them back to back and sort of focus on the transitions between the songs, so it felt a bit more seamless and like it was almost one piece, which is kind of how we did it in the recording of the album. I guess we split the songs more into sections and then we'd work with each section as like a body of work and how each one of those songs kind of connected to the other and flowed through. And we wanted that to kind of come across live, so there was a lot of planning ahead as to how we would do that.
We'd recorded the album pretty much in sequence, you know, we'd kind of recorded, you know, figured out the order and some of the transitions between songs and kind of grouped them and actually recorded them together in sections. So the whole thing's always felt very much a whole, you know, and the way that we mixed the record was mixing it rather than doing individual songs, we just kind of put all the songs in one session and just mixed the whole thing. So to me, that record, more than a lot of others, is one piece of music.
Stage with us, we had Nick playing viola, who's Lottie's dad, and Alex playing flute, and Charlie playing trumpet, and Ruben playing synth.
It was also very collaborative in the way that we worked with those extra musicians. You know, they very much like shaped the way that they would play their parts and wrote loads of like additions to it for the live performance to make it just that bit thicker and kind of more impactful.
Having all the extra musicians on was a really good idea for that show, because for a start, with a show that you're not supposed to move around, you can't dance and can't walk up, I don't know, there's not none of that sort of crowdedness and kind of like going to the bar to get a pint and not move, I don't know, it's just much more focused on the just watching and listening.
To have it played in its sort of expanded capacity.
Just hearing that sound, you know, it was so much bigger and it was so much more epic, and it's something that we're definitely interested in kind of developing on and expanding with. We also wanted the same connectivity that our art and set designs or photos had in our release of the album to stay with us on our live performance.
our good friend Flo, who designed the set for the Nunhead Alhambra session, she kindly gave a hand in doing the set design. So she painted these amazing sort of leafy backdrops, and all of her colour schemes were based off of the album artwork that Toby and Aidan did.
It was quite a simple design, three separate backdrops that hang behind us. It gave that feeling of it being not just a music performance, but almost like a piece of art in a way, like a theatre show. It felt like more of a kind of big deal than it would just, you know, flashing strobe lights and a kind of disconnectivity to what you're experiencing on stage and what you're experiencing as a audience member and a viewer of that thing.
I love playing PTST.
That's one of my favourites too. It's slightly different from all the others.
I love Rosie's vocals, and I love how sincere they are with the way that they sing. There's no sort of glamorising their voice, which I think is super refreshing. They kind of just sing how they talk and how they are. really love the ending of that song, with like all of the overlapping vocals and Lottie's guitar riff at the end. It's really good. When the audience claps and sings along, it still blows me away a little bit that people know the words to our music. It's an amazing feeling. It's really like incredibly touching, and like when that happens, I just can't help but kind of like almost like laugh on stage, not out of me finding it funny, but out of like pure euphoria. It's just like, it feels like you're connecting with people because the music that you're making is touching other people in such a overt way. And likewise, like their involvement, you know, Go wouldn't be the same as what it is without our fans. So, you know, it's a two-way sort of exchange of energy, which is just pretty amazing. playing Sad Cowboy, because there's just that level of that sense of euphoria that comes with that song and the building nature.
It's got like this sort of galloping beat to it, and it's nice to have people dancing along. We've always kind of made jokes about like kind of clapping along and like pretending to like introduce each member of the band as we do this kind of epic ending where everyone's kind of playing their own part until it builds and becomes like this really big dancey ending.
Thanks guys. those pills, how'd they make you numb? Find another way to get my fill.
Thank you.
Over the course of the shows, like, because our sets sounded different, it kind of meant that the favourite songs probably differed slightly between the two. The second show, my favourite song was probably Bang.
You weren't allowed to stand up, and most people obeyed that for most of the day. When Bang came on, everyone just jumped up and just ran forward, and the security guards were like, no, fucking just sit down. People just could not handle it, because it was just so uplifting and the groove was so hot.
In the middle.
Thank you. Hello. Sorry, bit of adjustment to do.
You see the brown, wither and brown, and all the guilt dripping over his mouth. Flick of the eye, showing the whites, showing another vessel's inside.
It's hard to broke, cannot contain all the lies they wrote.
Welcome back, our lovely musicians. Come on in. Come on in. Thanks so much for coming down, guys. This is our last song. Hope you enjoy.
Did it. We've accomplished this thing that is like quite a big thing for us, and we've sort of uplifted people in their moods and made them feel good at the same time. So it was a win-win situation, I felt.
In a way, it felt like more cinematic than people weren't really rowdy, like with drinks in their hands, being like, oh, I'm playing this song. It's like they were here to see us play, and like, because it was a headline show, and that made it feel really special.
It just felt really special to be able to all be there together and overcome the challenges that we faced and be able to finally play, and people to hear it and see the songs live that they've been listening to for a few months. In a way, it was quite nice because some people were more familiar maybe with the songs.
my dad play on stage was really nice. And he sort of ended up finishing the performance, and sort of we were all kind of trailing it out, and he kind of comes forth from that and almost had the sort of spotlight on him by the end, and did this quite grand sort of epic ending with his bow sort of like poised to the air. And I got to sort of like step back and watch that whilst it was happening, so I was sort of like done with my playing, and so it was kind of nice to have that moment.
It was a real spectacle, and it was just beautiful. And then we had a party afterwards.
I can give it a go.
I like, you know, like, so drunk.